Hello, and welcome back to the Orion's Arm Exploration Channel. Last time we introduced the Mu Empire. Today we will explore the geology and mysterious formation of the unnatural chlorine planets scattered throughout the known galaxy. To the best of our knowledge, life requires solvents to exist, and the earliest known solvent to Terrigen civilization is water. Water is even called the universal solvent. But what if there was something else in the water that could also sustain life as a solvent? What if that something else was hydrochloric acid? What type of biochemistry could possibly survive in such an environment? The type of biochemistry found in these sorts of environments is called Type 1b, and we'll explore Type 1b biochemistry more in a later video. Where might you find these environments? On normally rare planets called chlorine planets. So rare, in fact, that we shouldn't be able to find one in the Milky Way. However, Terrigen explorers have found 356 so far. How could this be? Well, to understand the answer, we have to delve into why these planets should be so rare in the first place. Normally, chlorine is quite rare in the universe due to the Otto-Harkins rule and its high mass. But on chlorine worlds, the element is quite abundant. How could this be? Chlorine worlds that form naturally would have to originate in regions of galaxies that have higher percentages of heavier elements. These chlorine worlds would have higher percentages of other heavier elements as well. Chlorine worlds generally are more massive than the average rocky planet because they have heavier elements in their system and thus more solid material to accumulate. But even if a planet has a high amount of hydrogen chloride at first, it can easily evaporate into space. So to develop into a life-sustaining chlorine planet, one must stay further from the home star than an Earth-like world. However, one risks becoming a gas giant or frozen if it goes too far out. So there is a narrow habitable zone for chlorine planets, which increases their rarity. The rarity of all of these conditions being satisfied simultaneously is why we should expect to not find any in the Milky Way if they only form in the way explained so far. When new data is unlikely given what we know, it increases the likelihood of alternative explanations where the data is likely, and decreases the likelihood of our starting explanation. How could we explain such a huge anomaly of not one, but 356 unexpected chlorine planets? Well, most of them became chlorine worlds around 780 million years ago. Additionally, explorers have discovered artifacts from an ancient advanced civilization nicknamed the Halogenics that was likely active over a brief period of about 780 million years ago as well. The probability that we would find 356 of them given the halogenics actively created a high number of chlorine worlds is much higher than the probability that we would find them given they formed naturally. So it's the prevailing explanation so far. How is geology different on chlorine worlds? In chlorine worlds, most rocks dissolve very quickly due to hydrochloric acid. Minerals such as gold and diamond are resistant to acids, so are commonly found across chlorine worlds. Due to high erosion levels, there is often very little exposed land. They also tend to have higher mass and more active mantles on average, so the combination of weight, rapid change, and rapid erosion makes their mountains very low in height. And that concludes this introduction on the geology and formation of chlorine planets. In a future video, we'll talk about the biology of the life inhabiting them, and how their biospheres tend to adapt to the high amount of hydrochloric acid. If you are interested, make sure to like and subscribe so you do not miss that video. We also cover many other topics on this channel. Well, anyways, thanks for watching, and goodbye, explorers!